ഓക്കെ, ഗുഡ് മോർണിംഗ് എവരിവൺ. സോ ഇന്ന് നമ്മൾ ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്യാൻ പോകുന്നത് ഡിറാക് ഇക്വേഷൻ പ്ലെയിൻ വേവ് സൊല്യൂഷൻ ആയിരുന്നു. കഴിഞ്ഞ ക്ലാസ്സിൽ നമ്മൾ സ്പിൻ ഓഫ് എ ഡിറാക് പാർട്ടികൾ നമ്മൾ ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്തു. ഇനി നമുക്ക് ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്യേണ്ടത് ഡിറാക് ഇക്വേഷൻ്റെ പ്ലെയിൻ വേവ് സൊല്യൂഷൻ എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഭാഗമാണ് നമ്മൾ ഇനി നമ്മൾ ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്യാൻ പോകുന്നത്. സോ ഒരു ഡിറാക് ഇക്വേഷൻ എങ്ങനെയാണ് നമ്മൾ പ്ലെയിൻ വേവ് സൊല്യൂഷൻ ചെയ്യാൻ പോകുന്നത് എന്നുള്ളതാണ്. സോ അതിന് മുമ്പ് നമുക്ക് ഡിറാക് ഇക്വേഷൻ ഒന്ന് എഴുതാം. ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ഐ h cross dou psi by dou t, which is equal to minus I c h cross alpha dot delta psi, which beta mc square psi. This is our equation 1. Okay, so over I h cross by dou by dou t, which is equal to I c h cross del dot alpha dot delta plus beta mc square is operating on a wave function psi of rt. So where we already know what is alpha is. Alpha is 0 sigma 0, and beta is I 0 0 minus I. Then we have psi as psi 1, psi 2, psi 3, then psi 4. Okay, because we have 4 by 4 matrix, the corresponding wave function will be also in 4 column matrix. Then alpha x is equal to 0 sigma x 0, and alpha y is equal to 0 sigma y 0. Okay, then alpha z is equal to 0 sigma z 0, where sigma x and sigma y sigma z are polymatrices which take the form 0 1 1 0 for sigma x, and sigma y equal to we have 0 minus i 0. Then sigma z is equal to Pauli's third matrix, which is 1 0 0 minus 1. Okay, so it is different title, sigma x, sigma y, sigma z and the parayunnathu. Okay, now we'll go to this Dirac equation, back to Dirac equation. So ivada psi of rt ennu parayunnathu, if I represent like this, u e raised to I k dot r minus omega t as the plane wave, then we need to find where u equal to, which has, it's a matrix with a u1 u2 u3 u4, and k dot r as you already know. Okay, so this is a matrix, okay, u1 u2 u3 u4, and if you proceed by taking, if you putting that equation, that is psi equal to rt, in the Dirac equation, then you will come across an equation and take the form I h cross into, okay. If you take dou psi by dou t, then there is a, we are differentiating with respect to dou by dou t, then there will be minus I omega u will come, okay. Minus I omega psi of rt will come, and which is equal to, then we have minus I c h cross alpha dot delta will be there. So alpha dot delta will have on the form of the form, if you take that, alpha x will be there, and correspondingly you will be having I x. Okay, so similarly it takes I x, then alpha y I y plus alpha z I k z. Okay, then plus beta mc square psi will be there. Okay, here also if I use, okay, if you just take this, they will have psi value here. Okay, so this is how it looks like. So if you just compare that, psi of rt you can cancel on the both side, then you will be having, finally you will be having h cross omega u, okay, h cross omega u, which is equal to c into alpha x h cross kx plus alpha y h cross k y plus alpha z h cross k z. This is h cross, not h, b, h cross k z plus beta m c square will come. Okay, so on the other side you will be having this function u raised to I k z, that function. Then already we know that E equal to, okay, E equal to h nu, so it can be in terms of h cross omega also we can write it now. Similarly, P can be written as h cross k. Okay, so it's coming from h by lambda, so from that you can convert it to h cross k. So by substituting these two, we'll have h cross omega is E u c into, how this h cross k came, so you by multiplying h cross k to all to the bracket, so you'll be getting this equation. Okay, then you will be having E u c. Okay, E u c will come, then del dot p working on u plus eta mc square u will come. Okay, so where u, already we know it's a matrix of u1, u2, u3, then e raised to, we just keeping u because we need to find out the solution for that plane wave solution, that's why we are keeping u in there. So eu can be written as c into del dot p plus beta mc square into u. Okay, where u, already we said u is equal to u1, u2, u3, then u4. Okay, this is the matrix corresponding to that, so which we can simplify as v by, sorry, v w. So we just simplified the matrix into v w, where v is u1, u2, and w is u3, u4. Okay, w is u3, u4. Okay, keep it as it like that. Now we have the equation corresponding to eu like this. Now we can substitute uvw as, for example, here you can substitute, instead of u, you can substitute that vw, that is vw, okay, which is equal to c into 0 sigma dot p 0 u, it's actually u, then we can give it as vw. Okay, vw plus mc square into I 0 0 minus I into v by w. Okay, so this is a different part. Okay, okay, so vw, so v by n. Okay, vw. Okay, so where, what we have done is that we have substituted alpha is equal to 0 sigma 0, then beta equal to I 0 0 minus I in that equation, then we got like this. Okay, so we got that like this. When you expand this equation, we will get ev, then evw as the two element of the matrix, which is equal to c into sigma dot p. If we just cross multiply this each other, we will get divided by w, then c sigma dot p into v. So as the first matrix, plus we'll have mc square v divided by, sorry, not divided by, mc square w. Okay, like you will get a three matrix like this in terms of matrix addition. Okay, now by comparing the first line of equation, we'll get EV equal to C sigma dot T W plus MC square V, which is equal to, which we can reduce to the form that by comparing both other side, like we'll be getting E minus MC square. So by comparing the V term together, V equal to C sigma dot P W. So this is our equation number 4 as of now. Okay, then E W is equal to sigma dot delta P by considering the second row. Okay, sigma dot P V minus MC square W. Here also, if you do the comparison by taking the V components on the other side, so we'll have MC square plus E plus MC square V, sorry W. Okay, yeah, E plus MC square W, which is equal to C sigma dot P V. So we got a two equation here, 4 and 5. And now if you just multiply fourth equation with E plus MC square, then we'll be getting E square minus M square C raised to 4 V minus, sorry, which is equal to C into sigma dot P E plus MC square, okay, into W will come. That is E square minus M square C raised to 4 into V, which is equal to C sigma dot P. This value already we know. What is E plus MC square W? E plus MC square W is C sigma dot P V. Okay, this already we have known, right? So this equation gives that C sigma dot P V equal to E plus MC square W. So we'll take the form like this. Okay, so also there is an identity. Now by using the identity, that is alpha dot A into alpha dot B, which is equal to A dot B plus I sigma dash dot A cross B, okay, or A into B. Okay, in that case, if you have a case like sigma dot P into sigma dot P, then which is equal to P square into we are getting P square plus 0. So if you substitute that in this equation, we'll have E square minus M square C raised to 4 into V, which is equal to, okay, which is equal to P square C square V. So that is E square minus M square C raised to 4 minus P square C square is equal to, or into V, which is equal to 0. Okay, so this is our sixth equation. So this P square plus C 0, how do we get from this relation? Okay, just take note of that. Okay, so there will be, from that we'll be getting that for a non-trivial solution, that is V not equal to 0, for a non-trivial solution from this equation, we'll get a for non-trivial solution where V not equal to 0, E square is equal to P square plus C square plus M square C raised to 4, that is E equal to plus or minus P square सी स्क्वायर प्लस एम स्क्वायर सी रेज टू 4 रेज टू 1 बाय 2. ओके सो इन क्लीन जॉर्डन इक्वेशन आल्सो वी आइडेंटिफाइड दैट द प्रोबेबिलिटी डेंसिटी इज इक्वल टू ई बाय एम सी स्क्वायर साई स्क्वायर वेयर ई इक्वल टू प्लस और माइनस सी स्क्वायर एच क्रॉस स्क्वायर के स्क्वायर प्लस एम स्क्वायर सी रेज टू 4 रेज टू 1 बाय 2 एंड देर वॉज एन इश्यू दैट द एनर्जी कैन हैव पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव वैल्यूज दैट इज नेगेटिव एनर्जी स्टेट वॉज वन ऑफ द इश्यू वेन वी आर deriving the Dirac condition. So we have taken that drawback of Klein-Jordan equation is the presence of a negative energy state, and in the probability density also getting negative as energy getting negative. So that was one of the issue of the Klein-Jordan equation. By even then in Dirac condition also we have the same problem. The Dirac condition also, if you take the rho of RT, that is psi star of psi, okay, psi star of psi, you will be finally ending up the same solution, okay, minus plus or minus c square p square m square c raised to 4 raised to 1 by 2. So that's what we have derived out here. From even using a Dirac condition, we are ending up in a state that there is a negative energy state is present. That negative energy state is also contributing the probability density, so the probability density also getting negative in that respect. So Dirac also cannot able to solve that negative energy state. So what it means is that there is an existence of a negative energy state is there. It's not a consequence of a Klein-Jordan equation or a drawback of a Klein-Jordan equation. There is a presence of negative energy state is there. So further, by evaluating the negative energy state, so we have to consider that the energy will be either positive, energy will be either negative. So there is a two condition can be there. So by considering that there is a presence of a negative energy state, so we are put forwarding the few more condition, that's to identify the eigenvalues for the negative energy and the positive energy states. What is negative energy state? That will be discussed in detail in the next lecture. Anyway, so for the time being, you have to understand that there is a presence of a negative energy state. So which further confirmed with the Dirac, or Dirac also could not sort out the issue of that negative energy state. Okay, so there is a presence of a negative energy state. That's a statement I need to put at this stage. So E minus mc square, so we have several equation already we have noted down, E minus mc square, which is equal to V C into sigma dot P V. So this is our fourth equation. And similarly, we have an equation E plus mc square into W, which is equal to C into sigma dot W, which is our fifth equation. Sorry, in this case it's W, right? So this is V. Okay. Then we have E equal to plus or minus P square C square plus M square C raised to 4. Okay. Raised to 1 by 2 as our seventh equation. Okay, our seventh equation, or the already we have proved it, right? So now we have the case is that there is two case, that is energy will be equal to E plus is equal to P square C square plus M square C raised to 4. So that is a positive energy state is representing. Okay, then we have E minus as, which is equal to minus C square P square plus M square C raised to 4, C raised to 4 raised to 1 by 2. So energy has a positive and negative values, then correspondingly there will be a change in representation of momentum as well, that we will see later. Before that, if you just represent the by solving the above equation, V equal to, we'll be getting C sigma dot P divided by W divided by e minus mc square, which is a value corresponding to e minus. Okay, e minus. Similarly, for e plus, we'll have w equal to c sigma dot p v divided by e plus mc square. Okay, so where m is the rest mass, okay, that you, so which is a function of v and which is a function of w. Okay, that you get to know. So what is v and w? V equal to u1 u2, w equal to u3 u4. Then if you consider that p equal to 0, so if you have a case p equal to 0, then e will be equal to what? Which is equal to e plus will be equal to mc square. Then if we have a case p equal to 0, e, okay, I think I wrongly put. Okay, so if in this condition, if you have minus will be equal to minus mc square. Sorry. So I just mistaken. Okay. Let me put it separately. Okay. Let me write it here. So if you have p equal to 0, okay. So here, if p equal to 0, then we have e plus e will be equal to mc square. And here if p equal to 0, then e minus will be equal to minus mc square. Okay. So we have two eigenvalues, e4 corresponding to e plus and e minus. So in order to find out that, so while first we will take e plus eigenvalue corresponding to the energy. E plus, for that what we'll do, we'll just see. Okay, in order to identify the eigenvalues corresponding to that, so we'll take that V and W are arbitrary matrices. Okay, arbitrary. So that is, we can take the two values, that is 1 0, okay, and 0 1. There will be two values can be taken by V. So where V, what is this? Is U1 U2. Okay, we can take the value 1 0 and 0 1. So by considering the equation W equal to sigma dot P V divided by E plus MC square, this equation, I already we said that this will equation can be considered for the eigenvalues corresponding to E plus, the positive energy state. So where sigma dot P equal to what is that? That is sigma x px plus sigma y py plus sigma z pz, and which can be written as in terms of 0 1 0 into px plus 0 minus i 0. What is sigma x and sigma y and sigma z? These are polymatrices, so we can take the form 1 0 0 minus 1 as sigma z into pz. Okay, by solving this, you will be getting the equation pz by pz px minus I py, then px plus I py minus pz will be your solution for that sigma dot p, if you substitute like that. Okay, now if you put that into this equation, then we'll have w as c by e plus mc square into pz px minus I py, okay, px plus I py minus pz, okay, into 1 0 means, so here we are taken v as 1 0, okay, So for this case we taken V as 1 0. Okay, then if you solve this matrix multiplication, okay, then you will be having the formula like this. So you'll have two value CPZ divided by E plus MC square. I'm just denoting the energy is positive into C P X plus I P Y divided by E plus MC square as my second term in the matrix. Okay, now we'll have a substitution here, that is, which is equal to, can be written as CPZ divided by E plus MC square as first term. Second time I return as C plus divided by E plus MC square. Don't be confused, I want to put that electric field, that is energy is positive. Okay, so there is two times only there in the matrix. So where Px plus Ipy we denoted as P plus. Okay, you just take a note of that. And the W can be written as, so W will be equal to, now we just take the C pi E plus MC square by taking outside. Okay, so this is the first case. Okay, so this is equal to W. Similarly, if you do that equation for V equal to 0, 1, okay, V equal to 0, 1, C by E plus MC square, PZ, PX minus IPY, PX plus IPY minus PZ, okay, into 0, 1, okay. Okay, so here you just note that we have taken the V as, okay, we have taken the V as 0, 1 here. Okay, so in that case the W becomes, okay, the W becomes C P X minus I P Y. Okay, so that will be the first one divided by E plus MC square, and you will be having minus CPZ divided by E plus MC square as the second solution. Okay, so which is equal to CP minus divided by E plus MC square, then we'll have minus CPZ as E plus MC square, here also E plus, okay, MC square. So we got two terms, right? Okay, we got W as two cases, that is when V equal to 0, 1, so you got W as this one. Okay, when V equal to 1, 0, you got W as this one, this equation. So you got two terms, right? So now we'll go to, now we can write U of 1. Okay, we all started the game with U, right? So U of 1, which is equal to VW. Okay, so what is VW means? So it is actually, so here we take that for the first case we have taken 1 0, and corresponding to that we have W as CPZ divided by e plus plus mc square, then c plus divided by e plus plus mc square are the fourth term. Okay, so I am just repeating what is v actually. It's a u1 u2 and w is equal to u3 u4. Okay, so what is u then? U is equal to u1 u2 u3 u4. So that's v represented here. Okay, so just not to confuse. So similarly, we have u of 2 also will be there. So that is vw, which is equal to, if you take v equal to 0 1, then we have a different value for w, that is cpy divided by e plus plus mc square divided by minus cp, so divided by minus cpz divided by e plus mc square. So these are the equations we will be getting. Similarly we can get eigenvalues for, okay, we can get e eigenvalues for e as well. Okay, eigenvalues for e minus as well, that's a negative energy state for also you will be getting the similar u1 and u2. So that's how we will get. There you have to substitute w, can take 1 0 and okay and 0 1, and by substituting in this equation v equal to c into delta dot alpha dot p w divided by e minus minus mc square. Okay, e minus represent the negative energy. Okay, then you will have u3 and u4 as u3 will be equal to vw. Okay, so here the change is what? So we will have a cpz will come here, then you will have e minus minus mc square, then c plus divided by e minus minus mc square will be the first two terms of v. For a w we will have the terms, for the first case we will have 1 0. Okay, 1 0. So this is the fourth four elements corresponding to that. Then similarly u4 will be, we can return as vw, which is equal to, okay, which is equal to, so here the first case is that we have a cp minus as the first term, that is e minus mc square divided by cp minus cpz, okay, divided by minus minus c square, then the w terms will be 0 and 1. Okay, so this is the case for w equal to 1 0 and this is the case for w equal to 0 1. Okay, don't be confused, just to try to understand. So what we have tried to understand, we got is that we got all the terms corresponding to u. So we have initially we said u equal to u1 u2 u3 then u4. Okay, so we got a three different formulation for the each one corresponding to the u1 u2 u3 u4. Okay, now we'll have a case where e equal to plus or minus p square c square plus m square c raised to 4. Okay, raised to 1 by 2. So that u is actually the solution for the plane wave solution, that is already we understood. Now we'll take a p tends to mc square. So in a non-relativistic limit, okay, limit, let p tends to mc square, then e plus will be approximately equal to mc square, then e will be equal to, e minus will be equal to minus mc square. Okay, also, so for a non-relativistic limit we can take e plus will be equal to mc square, e minus will be equal to minus p square, and for normalizing the wave function, for normalization of the wave function, so we can introduce that psi dagger psi will be equal to 1, and if you have a normalization constant for a case like here, if you take u of 1 as our one, a u of 1 star u of 1, then it will be equal to 1. With that we can identify the normalization constant by putting a equal to, so u1 of star means, so it has a value 1 0, सी पी जेड डिवाइडेड बाई ई प्लस प्लस एम सी स्क्वायर, ओके, देन सी पी माइनस डिवाइडेड बाई ई प्लस प्लस एम सी स्क्वायर, ओके, सो दैट इज आवर यू वन स्टार, ओके, यू वन स्टार, देन वाट इज यू वन, यू वन इज द करस्पॉन्डिंग कॉलम मेट्रिक्स, कॉलम मेट्रिक्स इज दैट 1 0 CP Z divided by E plus plus MC square, then C plus, okay, this is, okay, C plus divided by E plus plus MC square. Here how CP minus came, when you take the conjugate of U1, U1, if you, when you take the conjugate of U1, this P plus term, actually this U1 is actually C plus, right? C P plus. So P plus will convert to CP minus when you take the conjugate of that, because what we have taken P plus means, P plus is PX, P plus is, what is that? PX plus IPY, okay? So P plus char will be equal to PX minus IPY, which is equal to P minus. So that's why this term get is P minus. So if you just solve this equation, then which is equal to 1. So by normalization, from that we'll get the solution for the A is equal to, the normalization constant can be identified. So the first term will be 1 plus 0 plus C square PZ square divided by E plus plus MC square whole square plus C square into PX square plus PY square will come, divided by E plus plus, okay, E plus plus MC square whole square, okay, which is equal to 1. So this is our first case. From that A will be equal to, okay, A will be equal to, by solving this one, so you will be ending up that we have all the terms corresponding to 1 plus C square into PZ square plus PX square plus PY square divided by E plus plus MC square whole square, that is, we can write it as A equal to, okay, A equal to, you'll be getting, okay, sorry, this is equal to minus 1 by 2. Okay, we'll have, okay, entire equation is a minus. By putting entire equation, that is raised to minus 1 by 2. Okay, so this can be reduced in terms of 1 plus. So this is PZ square, PX square, PSY square. So all the components are there. So we can write it as simply C square P square divided by E plus plus MC square raised to minus 1 by 2 will be the normalization constant, okay, in that case. So similarly, for normalization constant for U2, U3, U4 also can be found out. So here you can see how the normalization constant found. So we all identified the plane wave solution for the case. So we have identified the corresponding plane wave solution and the plane wave solution. From that we identified that we able to the normalization constant, we find out where U we consider V equal to U1, U2, U3, U4. So we identified all the terms corresponding to U1, U2, U3, U4. So that's a, all the solution of the plane wave. So by Dirac equation, we are able to identify the plane wave solution. But still there is a problem exists. There is a presence of negative energy state. So that, so in detail about the negative energy states will be discussed in next lectures. Okay. With that, I'm winding up this session. Thank you.